And welcome back everybody here to the Frankfurt Major 2015 Open Qualifiers with the road to that sad place. We're gonna see is Team Empire able to take all the games as we're gonna be following them the entire day, yesterday, pretty much always throughout this entire Open Qualifiers. As the enemies are keep on being stronger and stronger, now we're gonna go up against the 5 stack here from Go Black. And let's see how it goes. Morality has something to say about it, I can already hear that.
Not much. Only that I can't see the frickin' first two picks for both teams now.
Can you actually see the bands?
Yeah, I can see those. Well, I'm gonna tweet it out right now, actually. This is exactly my vision. What is Val's? Okay, hang on, I can see it on stream. So it's Darkseid, Lina, Queen of Pain, Winter Wyvern. Alright, yeah, Team Empire.
You can just follow it from the stream. It is like, what is it, less than 20 seconds delay.
I will tweet that out though, what is going on.
Yeah, you should. I'll put the tweet up in the stream as well. You can do it yourself. But yeah, this is... Team Empire so far, we'll just go over the picks really fast and easy now. Because it's not that exciting. It's the Darkseid and Lina, you see their heroes all the time. It has some synergy in the Vacuum into LSA combination. It's a bit of practice as a team together, just to get the communication on that one right. Like, you know, Vacuum there, throw down LSA there, or say, you know, I'm throwing down LSA there, Vacuum them in, something along those lines.
You know what's funny words. Though? When you say Vacuum, it sounds like fuck you. I'm just putting that out there. Yeah, exactly.
How do I need to say it?
Like a Vacuum.
Vacuum.
Yeah, exactly.
Vacuum. Okay. Yeah. Vacuum. Yeah. My English pronunciation sometimes is weird.
Ah, it's fine. Anyway, so yeah, they've got that going for them. But then again, Queen of Pain, Winter Wyvern, they picked up the Queen of Pain, which is just really strong overall, and the Winter Wyvern, which they are comfortable with. We saw. No fear, Winter Wyvern is pretty okay, pretty decent.
Okay, and for everybody, by the way, that's watching right now, I can now give the result of MFF versus, Screen Squad, I don't know the name of them now, he always changes names, MFF lost. The squad of Screen is through to the round of 16.
Pretty good for them. We will meet them again eventually if they do make it through the round of 16.
Indeed. Dire team
pick. Well, I'm going to say...
Yeah?
Oh, you talk, please.
Oh, no, we're just going to say Team Empire again on the Radiant.
That's actually a good point, yeah.
That's
not something, you know, like... They really like the Radiant side. They really like just... Maybe it's just comfort zone again. The advantages it offers, though, are... You don't have the fast rock access of the Dire, but you have... Better mid lane available to the jungle, so
your off lane is stronger, is better because you have possibilities to get a hard camp to the lane, as well as well, in this case, Broodmother is now banned out, but you have more access to the jungle as well, better hiding spots with the webs.
So, overall, Radiant does offer some advantages over the Clockwork being picked by Team Empire, very strong off lane. Problem is, they a team like Priest have not picked a carry yet. Like, a Clockwork works really good overall, but now you can have the chance. You have the chance to basically just make sure you secure your carry. And especially with Alina, who, if you cog, can just Light Strike array you into your own cogs.
Yeah, it's kind of a setup for them in that sense.
A counter setup, really.
That's it. If you're Lina, you're caught in the cogs, you're kind of fucked. And if Clockwork gets a blade mill, it's also not that nice either. It's quite easy to also hit the LSA on top of a Cold Embrace. So. Though there's no real lockdown for Queen at the moment.
I'm probably thinking maybe of another Earthshaker pickup.
Or Bane.
That might be a possibility. Bane being picked up by Priest here. Very good lane support. And this should basically make the Clockwork very, very unhappy.
Yeah. As well as just the synergy between the Bane and Alina is also just all over the place. It's just there, like... It's just nightmare into LSA. There's nothing more about it. You just do that and you level 1, you're gonna get a kill.
what can you do as a clock? And like maybe Clockwork will go max rocket here to just be able to get a few vital last hits. Get a bit of vital gold here and not have to walk forward, but it's a very iffy build because it just, you know, it doesn't let you do as much DPS and forces you to be a nuker really, which no, you don't really want to be as a Clockwork, you want to be in their face.
No, you want to have the battery assault doing the damage, yeah. Not the rocket flare. That's not what you want.
But then again, if it does, I mean, maxing rocket flare has its advantages. Like I said, you can have a long range, have long range farming tool. And here we have a disruptor being picked up. So here's a bit of lockdown, but the problem is it's not really like hard lockdown in a sense.
Yeah, most of the things that they have right now is kind of like AoE lockdown. Apart from the ultimate from Winter Wyvern, it's all not indeed that hard lockdown that you want. Clockwork can get set something up with his Cox, but usually you don't have more than two people in your Cox. So it's kind of hard to get multiple people then in the Static Storm, unless if you use a Static Storm next to it. So use the Cox, so the Clockwork for one or two enemies, and use the Disruptor Ultimate for the other.
Well, that sounds like a possibility.
As now they have to go and play again against the Wraith King.
Oh. And this time, it might even be harder because now they have a Bane, now they have a Lina, now they have a Lockdown. Like, a lot of hard Lockdown as well. So this Wraith King will not be kited around as easily. Especially with the Dogs here as well, that will be problematic. Reserve time. So, entering into the final ban phase, that's bans will be...
So I'm just putting in your tree right now in the chat.
Right, TA banned out, PL banned out. PL being banned out here is an interesting choice.
Is it abuse blade?
Yeah, I can understand it as well. Also, there's not a lot of AoE lockdown on the side of Priest, other than the Darkseer.
And but the Lina a bit, but yeah, it's just not enough to keep him down, that's a problem. Like, a Bane is not a good versus a PL. First, you need to find the correct one.
Yeah.
And that's it. Like, you have to find the correct one. It's all solo target damage, so if you can't find the correct one, you're just screwed as a Bane.
Because all your mana is gone at that point. Yeah. And so yeah, Bane, good ban here, as well as the TA, who they decided they did not want this intense single target damage, which will more than obviously be coming out here.
Indeed.
But that, you know what? That still leaves Shadowfiend in the pool.
You don't want to position one Shadowfiend, at least not against the Bane, Darkseer, Lina.
No, not for Team Empire, not for Team Empire.
Oh, for Priest.
Yeah, but they pick up the Jericho instead.
Let's see, Priest. I have their one and only game. I think I had it up like a second ago and now I lost it. Ah, screw it. I'm gonna go back a little bit. Ah, here. They did pick it up for Barashik. But they had a save lane farming gyrocopter.
Dead Empire decided to pick up the gyrocopter, so they've got a bit of AoE. They have a lot of AoE. Empire has a huge amount of AoE, actually. But the problem is Priest has a lot of single target, and you can always... It's always a good question. What happens when you have single target added in with the AoE of the Darkseer against a team which has a huge amount of AoE damage but hasn't got too much lockdown?
I think in the end, at this moment, Priest draft just looks a bit stronger here. If they actually have Lina and Bane as the combination to gank with,
yeah,
it's going to be so hard, and yeah, they will as they pick up the Shadowfiend. I was thinking maybe Lina mid, and then pick up a Mirana as support next to it to go with the Bane, but this works just as fine.
Yeah, so I call that one. That's all I'm going to say. No, Yeah, so they have a pretty strong lane lineup right now. The early game should go the side of Priest anyway. Like, Clockwork is going to have such a hard time on this lane if they do it well.
And the only thing is that in mid, Queen of Pain against Shadowfiend, it's a matchup that we have seen many times already.
Yeah, it's a good old obvious one. It really just it depends on the skill level, but mostly... Oh, instant TP resolution. He wants to aggressively ward here.
He wants to get his things down as he the boots he accidentally forgot to buy them on time, so those are still... Well, he has the money left. Maybe he wants to buy something else.
Gonna get the courier to do that for him, most likely.
No, he sold the item.
Oh, okay. Well, anyway, you want to present Empire?
Yeah, I got the other team last time, so this might be the last time. Maybe not here in the open qualifier for the Frankfurt Major, the road to it by Team Empire. Let's see if they can win this one with Silent on the Gyrocopter, Yoki on the Queen of Pain, Aloha Dance on this all too much famous Disruptor here. We have seen him on many teams with it. No Fear on the Winter Wyvern, Wyvern, yeah, and Resolution on the Clockwork.
Alright, and for Priests, we have Barash playing the Shadow Fiend, Recovery playing the Wraith King, Go Black, not in a pro team anymore, instead making this team and trying to get through the qualifiers, Bane playing the Bane, Cat playing the Lina, and last but not least, Poshka playing
Miposhka?
The Dark King. Miposhka?
I think that's it. I'm not, yeah.
Miposhka.
Yeah. If we're Eastern Europeans, we might be able to pronounce the one correctly, I guess.
Well, at least their names aren't too bad. They're not Arabic symbols or something like that.
Yeah, or just random scribbly things put down and you're like, what? What's that supposed to be? So then you start people calling, then you just call them Ogre Magi and stuff.
It could either. Do you want to address people by name? It's always nice and personal.
Barash, he...
Let's have a look at the beginning few items, so...
Barash is going back for the Brave Band. It's going to be delivered in Korea.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Lina?
Lina only has consumables. Got a smoke up, so already some early smokes maybe coming out here.
Yeah, that you have a Bane and Lina combination, you have to be aggressive. There's like no question in my mind that I need to do that, and it will. Otherwise it won't work out.
No consumables is all consumables. You see that a lot, but you know she probably will be playing a more position 5 carry. Although she's kind of greedy, Alina is kind of greedy as a support, isn't she?
She needs her levels. That's the most important thing. Like after that, yeah, you know it's nice to get farming. You can get the yields. Like that's just nice, but you don't really need it if you can just have somebody else maybe take up the initiation role, like the Darkseer or possibly the Bane.
But once again, we're having a look at the Darkseer as well. Rift King works as an
JTM. Gaunt is Gaunt. Okay. Well, we'll believe you there, Copperfield, here, I guess. Because I really don't know. But yeah, you were going to talk about?
Anyway, yeah, what was it talking about? Like, the Darkseer, you know, we saw yesterday in one of the games how the Darkseer was just completely cancelled out. And I don't think it's going to happen again here. Maybe it will to a lesser extent, but, you know, if Empire can play this well and keep the Darkseer out of the game until, like, 20 minutes, they should have a pretty strong lead.
Yeah, I would say their safe lane is pretty well equipped to deal with it. All heroes are ranged. The Glimpse is... It's just a natural counter against the Darkseer in the lane. Same as the Fissurist from Earthshaker, for example.
You only need to, and really, like you said, range. They can just stay at range of the Iron Shell and the push will work towards their to their favor.
Yeah, the one thing is that with that you do give up farm to the Darkseer, but not levels. So, which he desperately needs. He needs like level 3 at least.
And here we go, we will continue.
Yes, Darkseer is also looking for a nice ward here. This will show if they're going to go for a pool or not here with the Dire Vision. Let's see for the Radiant. Yeah. This is Vision here is also nice. They can show if they go for the double pool as well, or is a gank on him. They might be able to spot out smokes as well if they're uncareful on the side of Priest and warn up himself or his mid laner.
I really want to watch this clock now. They are pinging him out heavily. He is going to try and do that famous block here with the cogs.
Yeah, that's, he should be able to do it, and there's nothing Priest can essentially really do about it. If they want to do something about it, they need to walk up underneath the lane here between the tier 1 and tier 2, and that's just too early to do that.
Let's see, if he gets this block off, that will secure him level 2 early, and that is really something very good. So not a lot depends on this block. It is pretty good block to get off, and oh, the range creep is in fact left forward, so that should be really okay actually, because it will.
Yeah, you want to have that one dead instantly. That's the creep that pushes. Guys, if you ever want to push a lane, kill the range creep first.
Unfortunately, one of the elite creeps was let through, so.
Yeah, then you lose two creeps, it's not that bad anyway, as long as the lane pushes in.
Push will not be as hard as he wanted it to, but it will be okay.
Yeah, he just wants XP from the first two creep waves. He can just keep on doing that, and the creep wave will always go back to him. Darkseid's going fairly aggressive against Olodance here. Yeah, that's not something he's going to win in the end. Olodance not scaling up anything.
Especially with the silence as well on the back lines. He activated Flash Cannon, skilled Flash Cannon first. Knowing there's not going to be much of an early engagement going on here to begin with.
Yeah, he just does. Every time Darkseid comes close, they just want to harass him. But he has still a bunch of consumables, so he's not that bad off.
You know, Drycroft even bought a mango. Not something you see every day.
Why not? You know, he is a little bit starved on mana with having his intelligence, the nerfs, I believe 2 patches ago or 1 patch ago or something.
I guess.
Regen is, it's always nice against the Darkseer who's gonna hit you with Iron Shells some way or the other. It always happens.
You can't touch him. Why is it staying mid with Queen of Pain? The Shadow Fiend of Souls, and yes, he does, so.
Yeah, once he has some souls, as you can see, the Bane just instantly goes out. Go block. We'll take the rune. If it's a haste rune, he might just run up straight up and is able to catch the Clockwork of Guard. As, let's see.
It's only a regen, though.
He can see him, yeah. The regen won't help him anyway.
And Yuki nice once again being very aggressive with his Queen of Pain. Deciding to sacrifice a lot of his life, a lot of his HP to just do a bit of damage to the Shadow Fiend, which will get that regen rune and heal that up very quickly.
What nightmare? Are they gonna go underneath the tower here? They seem to be wanting to do is LSA, of course, connects for 8-5. That's nicely followed up here as they're able to just pick up that kill.
That's the single target. There is so much single target on that side. But the problem is Darkseid just died for the first time.
It's 1-for-1.
And to be honest, Clockwork, slightly better off, I'm going to say. Level 3 to Darkseid, level 3. Okay, never mind.
In the end, this is going to be victory for Priest first, because they are the one who gets the first spot. The last hits in that sense is also pretty much the same. Both of laners are doing about the same, apart that Resolution has to walk up there. So with that, this engagement really goes in the hands of Priest, or engagement, the 1-for-1 trade, I guess.
I mean, first blood is always nice to have.
Indeed.
And this is going to be a problem for Resolution, though. Once again, on his offlane, he's having a hard time.
Yeah, he has to look at that all times, because they can just jump him.
At least Bane's gone for now, so he has a bit of space.
Goblock is in a base.
Now he's coming back, and... Let's see what his next skill level will be. See if he goes with more of a rocket. Okay,
what
this
Empire?
Is very
no, Resolution. That's not what you're supposed to do. Red Fire Blast to follow him up. They're just gonna leave the Nightmare maybe for less, but they don't really need it anyway, as Recovery can just pick up the kill.
And that's the second death on the offlane. At that point, you need to tell yourself, okay, I need to play defensively. Very defensively now.
Why the hell is the game so lagging again? What is fucking up with that? That's so fucking weird.
I like Yoki's Queen of Pain play, so it's always so aggressive. He jumps in, throws a dagger, does a bit of light click, and then blinks out immediately. Loses a lot of health in the process, but secures that the Shadow Fiend just doesn't get any mana. Who now immediately gains it back because of that bounty rune.
Yeah, it's... One thing about this way of playing Queen of Pain is that you have already a loss in the bottle regeneration. It went from 140 HP to 110, so in that sense it's a little bit harder to do well. Oops. Resolution being a little bit too fast there on the Cox.
That's a smoke that Bane. Lina was spotted out though, so Yoki
they know
should
it.
Recognize, yeah. Danger coming out here.
I think both teams know, like, Kent knows it as well as the side of Empire. Here you can see it, they just put in this illusion of Queen of Pain in the front to try and get them to do something here, as they now see everybody walking up here with the Observer Ward on the high ground.
Yeah, this Darkseid is now in a bit of a pickle though. No, you should be fine. Oh, Yoki. Aggressive play is getting punished.
Oh, I wasn't watching there. I was watching at the docks here, and Boto was changed the charge. It'll pull out a bit.
You see, this is Yoki's, like, see, this is Yoki's dilemma, right? He does these aggressive plays, but always seems to mistime something in the end. It takes way too much damage for his own good.
Yeah, and by doing that, you just give...
Oh, Doxy!
Also dead. Oh man, they're just starting to get kills all over the map every time I'm gonna look somewhere else. So annoying. So now Yoki is a bit behind the Shadow Fiend, about one level. Couple less hits, about five or so, so... That's it. Against Goblack, he should be fine here in the lane. No kill potential coming out from him. Until somebody rotates in, and he might be able to get off a nightmare just before anything happens. So lower dance.
And that's level 6 already upon Shadow Fiend. Level 5 Queen of Pain, so definitely a 1 mid lane for Shadow Fiend here. Although last hits look similar. One kill will make a difference.
Yeah, you can see in the net worth, it's about even. It's just really just those... That extra kill, aka the first blood for Priest, that's making the difference. Apart from that, it's just even Steven.
Recovery seems to be winning over the Silent, but that does make sense considering Silent is up against a Darkseer. He's doing relatively well for himself versus the Clockwork, who's still level 3.
Level 5, 3, they're winning at the moment. A couple more or less hits, but those are fairly neglectable. Just those 4s. Actually, not 4. I was looking at the load and said, no, it's actually 8.
That's a lot.
That's a nice amount to be ahead.
But it's a dark, so remember, he does farm very good on the offlane. Iron Shell.
As well as he has the potential to go back into the jungle and just farm something up there. His resolution on the Clockwork is forced to get his farm out of the lane somewhere. You can use Battery Assault to farm up the jungle a bit, but it's not really that effective.
Really? I only think he needs some levels right now. Just get someone to lane with him, and it seems like Winter Wyvern is in fact coming up to him.
Okay, so Necto has been able to translate whatever Resolution was saying. It appears to be Aloha's headphones aren't working currently, so they boss for that. He will be most likely getting a new set now. A bit of technical issues there. Is my mic hissing?
No, that's just the waterfall on the top lane.
I was thinking, what? I don't think it's the waterfall, I think it's the clockwork or not. Yes, the clockwork, I think he just shut off his...
Oh, okay. Yeah, I've never noticed like that sound before. I was wondering where it was coming from. It sounded like the waterfall here, but...
It's kind of like a waterfall, but the waterfall don't make any sounds, so...
Imagine the ambience. Anyway.
Yeah, just let's see the next match for Empire, by the way. It might just be PR. If they win this match, PR is the most likely candidate. Yeah, it's Lurikeen Rockets. It's the Rocket Flare that Clockwork sent up. I was already wondering how many technical issues I'm going to get today.
This Rocket Flare is actually really annoying.
Yeah, why do you... Just think about it. When you're in a Captain's Mode lobby... you're not allowed to move your camera. So, at the moment, Resolution is stuck listening to that sound.
Well, good luck to him. Hope he survives that.
Yeah. You're just gonna get a headache from that one. They need more heroes here in mid if they want to do something about the Queen. No, I don't look at top, that's stupid. Okay, there we go, cameras off it. Now there's a lag in TeamSpeak for Empire, they always have problems at the moment. Soul Ring is done for me, Pushka, but the courier is a little bit on the wrong side of that. That doesn't matter, I don't think he has his Ring of Health anyway. For Silent, his Aquila is gonna be... Well, it's almost completed. Aquila's gonna be brought up. He just needs a Sage Mask. As Goblas says, something with numbers. Maybe somebody can translate it for us again.
Yeah, Nectar, doing a great job. Do more of it.
Yeah, for the people that want to hear the TP sound, here you go. It's for you guys.
Beautiful, beautiful. The music is just beautiful. Anyway.
I should find some VOD-free music that I can just play during this time as well.
Elevator music, I guess.
Yeah. Watch something. Anyway. For the early game, you know, at the moment it can still be, you know, relaxing. Nothing is really going to go and happen in the upcoming 20 seconds. So.
Maybe. No, not even resolution will probably right. die again since, yeah, Bane is down there.
No fear's rotating up, so maybe something with that. But
yeah. I said, like, maybe he's gonna get some help so he can get a few levels at least.
No fear, you like not waiting. I guess they have some perf history. I've guessed multiple matches where actually we had the players going at each other at the ranked because they played a ranked match before it. And they were actually in the same team and they were shouting at each other later in the lobby for how much of a fill they are. It was really funny to see. I think it was a PR match versus somebody.
You know, it's always the banter between pro teams. It's always funny to see.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, look at this. Winter Wyvern and Clockwork. They're starting to do something together. They even have a smoke up. Ooh.
Yeah, but the level 3 Clockwork, what's he gonna do?
Oh, he's gonna cog, I guess.
Yeah, then we need Slung with Arctic Burn to do something. Maybe use the poison from the co-op as well. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Science goes, oh, they want to do something aggressive with science as well. The manga
this
might just come in play here now.
Smoke. Yeah, and he has level 6 as well.
The Wave King's level, yeah, they might just be able to turn this one around. Let's see. Okay, that TP is on cooldown. Go Black doesn't have a TP, so he will need to walk up. Gunt doesn't have a TP, but he's already there.
Dear,
oh, they're looking for mid. They're looking for mid. Okay.
This is going to be very. This might even be 2 dead heroes if they do this correctly.
Okay, they're gonna find Goblock first. It means that Barrage just has to run away and leave Goblock behind. They're gonna get a poison of. Oh, he got hit as well by the cauldron. He's gonna take a fall here. He's winding up the Wreck himself, but doesn't matter.
What? Oh,
recovery came in! This is not good. He's gonna lose his life once. They're gonna. No, what? He's still alive. Okay, Silence gets it right here with a Flak Cannon. Gun comes in. This is Stand Up Silence. Stand Up Silence. Another TP will come in, another one as well. Okay, they're gonna have 4 people here in mid as well for Priest. And they're gonna get silent here first. There you go with the magic damage from the LSA and the Iron Shells. They're actually able to turn this one around at the price of the Shadow Fiend, the Bane, and the Reincarnation.
Be honest though, it was still Silent still gained some gold for that. Even though he died, he still gained a 54 gold.
I and think 223 XP, which is more than the others did. The other side.
So it's a good trade for Empire here. I mean, of course, you don't want to lose your core in any sense, but you did take down one of the enemy cores, and you did take down a very annoying support. And you also managed to force out Reincarnate, which is great as well.
Yeah, that means for 5 minutes, Recovery is going to be playing passive.
And like I said, Resolution is actually maxing Rocket Flare, knowing that he's going to have a very hard time if he doesn't.
Yeah, this is what we talked about. If you're gonna have a top lane, you're most likely gonna be leveling up your Rocket Flare. Going for battery soul is nice and all, but you're not gonna be able to fight up against anybody when you're in their leveled anyway.
And we did gain 2 levels from that though, which is great. Although Darkseer is now level 7, so it's iffy.
What do you think? Is he gonna build threats with this Rope of the Magi, or is he just gonna use it for blade mail?
I'm gonna say he's gonna go for blade mail here. Although I don't know really, that's kind of a good question.
Because you can build both with the items, so.
Yeah. It really depends on what he gets next. Like, if he gets a plate mail next, then he will be probably building up. No, plate mail. Chainmail. And then he will probably.
Rich person.
Plate mail, yeah, he's got 1,000 gold on that, hasn't he?
He's almost there, almost there.
No, if he gets a chainmail next, then obviously it will be for the plate mail.
And look at this, they're gonna go aggressive here again with Silent in the smoke as well. They're gonna have the supports plus him rotating top.
This is how EG played with the Gyrocop as well in TO5. They
no,
just
aggressive.
Used it. Sorry, yes. Aggressive on C deck. They used it incredibly. No, hang on. EG Fear did as well.
Yeah, but aggressive was the one who really showcased it. And
oh,
there we man. Go, Barrage.
Oh, no.
Yeah, you just get caught out here and you're gonna die. Even a Rocket Flare took him afterwards.
Like, I want a bit of the action here. Here's
Gimme Gil, kill, gimme Gil, gimme Gil. I deserve it. okay, it's gonna be the Blade Mill first. Pretty nice. Laguna should be up fairly soon, level 4, still some time to go, but still return a nice chunk of the damage. Blade Mill's now also completed on Rave King as he's stuck here. Are they gonna be able to find him? No, they won't. Ooh, yeah, this is the good target to do this on.
Nice.
They just switched the aggro from the Nightmare, so they can still get a glimpse up onto Goblack. He's gonna take a fall here as Empire Tech's kill hookshot comes in as well. The Observer Ward just recently placed here. LSA is gonna be on the mark, so they need to chase further if they want to go for this, but Glimpse is on cooldown for another 15 seconds, so they might just have to cancel it off as they will.
Blink was also on cooldown for the Queen of Pain, so they, she couldn't have. If she had Blink there, she might have been able to go in and do a Scream. A Scream into a Sonic Wave and maybe kill off the Lina. Don't know if you wanted to waste a Sonic Wave for that, but, you know, it might have been a possibility.
They just have so many levels already on a lower dancer. Level 7 on the Disruptor at 11 minutes is really nice. Having a level 4 Glimpse, man, you need to watch your steps now.
Oh yeah, it's like the range is insane. Also, I really want to see some Fountain Glimpses. We haven't actually seen too many.
Well, that means that they're just standing correctly as well.
No, it means that TPing incorrectly.
Yeah. No, you tend to not TP in the front of the tower when you're against a Disruptor. That's,
you know, it's just, it would just be funny to see, like, actually once. It would probably even be like, we probably won't see it in these phases of the game, but maybe during an intense team fight, if Disruptor gets a lucky glimpse off onto someone TPing in.
So he received a immortal item for him. And zero heroes Klimt. So he doesn't play this hero on this account in pubs.
Ah. Well, can't fault him for it.
I guess he doesn't want to play it outside of competitive on this account. But maybe he plays it on his Smurf.
You have a look. Level 4 Rocket Flare up on Clockwork, so he's going to do a bit of hurt during these fights. Too much damage isn't much.
But still nice AoE, so if you combo it up with a cooldown, Static Storm and Sonic Wave, it starts to add up. No, Hookshot is up. Hookshot is actually up, so he might be able to go here for Iposhka. Yeah,
I think they want to. They really want to here. Just out of range right now. No, just in range. No, they will back off. But it not to risk it. They didn't know his location exactly, so rather than waste a hookshot, better just do something else. Watch it. I think he wanted to stack that camp.
Who?
Clockwork.
He failed?
I think so.
It sucks. The hard camp?
Yeah.
I succeeded in that one. At least it stacked once. I don't know if he wants to go for it.
No, that wasn't him. That was, I think that was someone else.
Probably I didn't know that one.
Anyway.
I was just looking a bit at the enemy jungle. Dire jungle, that is.
He was about to come up with Queen of Pain. Barash, meanwhile, is about to actually finish a BKB. He's 1,200 gold off. Probably easy stacks for him. Should get in around 2 to 3 minutes. And Wraith King has 1,800 gold saved up, probably saving up for a blink.
Yeah, that's the most likely item.
Oh,
okay, here's
nice.
The hookshot on Goblock. He's gonna get up the Nightmare, but it doesn't really matter when you have a battery assault next to you.
And Resolution is gaining all those levels back that he missed.
Yeah, this is just how you see a lot of people play Clockwork. You know, you have a shit lane, so you get some kills somehow. You need to get your level 6 from it, friends. Or from higher, from level 6 and higher.
Just the hookshot being so versatile. Oh, and they will see Wraith King. Disruptor wants this badly.
No, he's just keeping tabs on it. This is all what this Thunder Strike is for. He's just to keep fishing so he can TP out. There you go. Now I put in the kinetic field. It's just waiting for Rico.
TP's though.
Yeah, okay, here you go. Blade Mill. They're just gonna wait it out. See, they take the distance. They're just gonna slow him up a bit, keep him there. And now they're gonna go for him. But his team is there now as well. It's gonna be a 5-on-5 engagement here. So Gruffy is still alive. Back here, but the Static Storm kinetic field here is just keeping them all in. The Wombo combo is real. There are 3 down counting the reincarnation here. Curse on Silent on recovery now, but he's still alive as Silent just clips the wall here and dies as well. Priest is gonna be able to maybe turn this one around. Lowdance gets off the glimpser to the back. Yoki is now here. Oh, he gets Laguna in the face, but is able to at least blink out. It's gonna be a 3-for-2 trade at the moment.
Three for three here. That's the Fiend Spirit. Whoa! Okay, that was a risky thumb.
He's here.
Okay, he's gonna die now to Goblet. As he gets
and
to kill a lower dance.
It was not even worth it. It wasn't even worth it.
Look at his Darkseer.
But Dioki on the back lines. In fact, the Alola Dance will get out, and here comes Winter Wyvern.
Our recovery blinks away, goes into TP, and we'll be able to survive. Yeah, Yoki gets in there now, but it's already too late. And even then, there was no way to stop this TP. Yeah,
Empire definitely won this fight, though. They managed to wipe out all of Priest's heroes, even though some came back.
Recovery still got hit by the scream.
Ah, that's a shame. Radiant's middle tower. They only lost three, although they did lose their core and their offlane. Priest lost everyone, and... the thing is, though, gold and XP change weren't that hard. Yeah, I've got it up right now. Empire only winning 400 gold and Priest, no, and only winning 700 XP of Priest here. So the Wombo combo AoE, the Wombo combo AoE going on from Empire there definitely helped, but the problem is, Dion wasn't able to stay alive long enough to be able to deal enough DPS during that fight.
Yeah, he got focused as well, and I think he would have died anyway, but in the end he kind of died to his own small misplay, because he should have been able to walk around the wall there, but got clipped on the very end. They're gonna go aggressive straight away. Ultimates are up, apart from Sonic Wave, they will be up in 10 seconds. As they're gonna go, who they're finding? They're not finding anybody for now, they find the ship. So Barrage, they're gonna go with the hookshot on top of him, they're just gonna keep him there. He's trying to get up the Requiem, Yuki. Yeah, that ain't gonna work, you just look like an idiot. As you die.
Probably just wanted to do the whole swag dance there.
Yeah,
as
kinda...
Rape, as Elephine does.
Yeah, it's kind of the same as what is it, when you cog in a Spirit Breaker and he tries to use his ultimate.
Look at... they are going on silent.
Yeah, smoke gank after smoke gank from both sides.
He should recognize. He recognizes the danger. He starts TPing out, but the vacuum should be there.
There you go.
Rip silent.
Pull backwards. And now he knows he's dead. What will they all use for him? No ultimates, but he will get off his own, dealing some damage. But really, that's about all. And I don't think they care too much about that on the side of Priest.
Will Empire re-engage with this? They can't. Can they? They can get recovery down, but he's on level 2 reincarnate.
It's already up again, so even if they just kill it off now, it's not that big. As he's just gonna spread through it, his LSA is gonna hit and a kill off no fear here on the Winter Wyvern.
Charges on to search. I think they wanted to pop Recovery's Reincarnate before
using any ultimates or big commitments.
But in the end, they failed and even lost the Winter Wyvern, so now they might even have a tier 2 being threatened here. It's taking a lot of damage already. Resolution is pushing its top lane.
Yeah, the TP in recovery there, we can just then go and farm this lane. We're actually getting quite low, 100 HP. With a hookshot, it should have been able to pop it, but they didn't want to go for it.
Yeah, there's no escape available for resolution at the moment, so he probably would have ended up dead anyway. Oh, he might actually. No, that's too much health.
About 40 HP. Let's see. 3 second TP, what's the TP down to base? It's like also 3 round. I think he might have been able to get out if he just instantly TPs after he killed him. Or is it 2.4? What's the basic TP time?
I think it's 2.4.
2.4, yeah, then he actually had time because reincarnation takes 3 seconds. But then you're what is it? Yeah, 70 second cooldown for a. Was it 140, right? 160. Okay, it's still worth it though. It's worth it to do that threat, especially if you stay alive, that's right. That's the trade ultimates pretty much, you know, trade the...
Ooh, are they risking Rosh right now?
No, they're not. They're not gonna do that. They're gonna smoke up. Yeah, I think they're gonna go and look for a kill.
But Empire realized this. Do they? Yes, they definitely do. The way they're standing up there, they definitely realize this, yeah.
Recovery is gonna blink in aggressively. Okay, he's gonna get the Wave Fire Blast on resolution. There's gonna be a free script as well. He's gonna be the first one to fall. Cowdown is gonna clip the supports here on the end. Recovery, nice curse. Good damage. All locked in here. But Barrage wasn't. He's getting in some hits. No Fear is gonna die here. There's gonna be the buyback coming out of resolution. So Lower Dance is gonna take the spill here. Resolution is going to fight against Recovery. He's gonna win this fight. It's Blade Mill against Blade Mill, but Yoki is there to help out. There's gonna be the Laguna resolution as resolution gets off a dieback here. Gunt, can he kill Yoki? Yes, as Yoki is able to save himself by using the Yules.
Empire gets off the top here on the nick of the teeth.
Yeah, this is like a 5-for-4 trade.
And they even managed to force that, yeah, so 5-for-4 because of the buybacks. And yet they still come out on top. Not so much on top, but really, they managed to gain a bit of an advantage. What's also funny is net worth is very even right now, as well as the XP.
Yeah, 20 minutes in, and Empire is not 5k ahead. This is not the Empire we know.
Die back by Clockwork, but it did manage to get something done. That's what I find really good.
Yeah, so it's just the Clockwork. Yeah. This is actually the first time that I see Empire down in towers. It's just one though. Goblox and oh no, Barrage. This is the one you wanted. Not worth to pop the BKB for that.
Yeah, no, not a 9 seconds. Yeah, he even popped the BKB during that fight. Still lost out. That's not too great, actually. The Requiem was pretty nice, though. I have to give them that.
This
but they just lost against the wombo combo that is Empire.
Well, they got really close, though. It was really just a buyback. Because also, I think Empire also knew that if they actually lost the fight over there, that they will lose their tier 2.
Might as well just take the tier 1 mid now.
Yeah, and get Disruptor close to his Aghanims.
Yeah, they don't have an Alchemist farming it for him now. And no. Aghanim's up on Queen of Pain, which will mean she can just spam out that wave whenever she wants.
Yeah, look at this. This ward was a little bit too obviously placed with the vision here. Gets instantly pinged out by Kant and almost likely just going the ward, and now I have both supports have sentries. Smoke is just being brought to no fear.
BKB about to come up on Gyro.
Sonic Wave used to push out the lane.
What is Rinkin gonna get next? He has his blink, he has his armlet, he has a raid mail. Do you think he could get an AC next?
AC or BKB. That said, BKB is not worth as much anymore unless you can get it off, because Disruptor is gonna get his Aghanims.
Oh, they know they're going rush. Oh, they know they're going rush.
Everybody knows they're going rush. Even they now know that they're not gonna go rush anymore, because Empire knows that they're gonna go rush. It's just too dangerous. If you're caught in the wombo combo of Empire in the rush pit, which is...
Oh, but the rest I still think. Empire still think they're going rush.
They might just get off the flare now. Use the flare to check. But they don't. I think they're just gonna walk up the hill here. Yeah, Resolution knows it. He gets off the rock flare, but he gets found by Recovery and he will just die here. Golden Ray is not enough to get him through there, as now they're all gonna go in. BKBs are pop. Curse is gonna go on to Mikiposha. Yeah, but he will survive through all it all, as Empire is taking heavy casualties at the moment. As they're just gonna try and get Kant here, as Silent gets low, but he will survive. Kant will survive as well. Yoki gets a godlike tree here. And now, nice Sonic Wave killing off the Lina here in the backline. Now Recovery, aggressive blink forward, find Yoki, he can blink any second, there we go. He gets out, now Silent is on the run, it's a 3-for-2 trade so far, Priest is on the upper hand. As, Silent, use defog, they can't see him, Recovery can't see him. He is able to get free, as Recovery TP's out towards the top to farm it up.
Oh no!
What? Yules is there, they wanna go for him, he doesn't have reincarnation for another 2 minutes. He might just get caught out here as his team is not able to help him. Silent is low, so he's kind of... He's just waiting. They're all waiting. And there's the hookshot. That's what they're waiting for. Crawdon gets popped as No Fear gets the kill.
Very greedy plays from Wraith King, and it did not pay off. And it was now 3-for-3, but Empire, I think, came out on top there. Slightly. Only slightly, though. Getting... they didn't lose any of their cores, which is great, but they lost a bit of gold in that fight.
Yeah, the only core lost in the end. Yeah, you can see Darkseer as a core, I guess. And but then you see Resolution as a core. I guess, apart from the offlaners, only Resolution as real core lost.
Oh, getting a kill on the Wraith King is always nice to have.
Indeed.
And
you can see Wraith King... it's a small dip and it goes straight up, so I think they won the fight indeed in the end. I wasn't able to get up any fight recaps because there were like two separate fights.
There, the first one was about 800 on the side of Priest. The second one was 600 for the side of Empire, I believe.
So in the end, they get the money value back due to the fact that they're able to farm more effectively with more heroes.
It's just that, like, the Kyoki's play is incredibly aggressive, but and yet they pay off all the time. And as well, Resolution, they're using the Resolution as just, like, you know, in chess, they're using him as the sacrifice.
Well, you can't really do anything else because he just has a play mill, like.
But the thing is, though, I feel like it's sort of going back on them. They're losing a hero at the very beginning of the fight for what? Nothing, really. So they lose a hero in the very beginning of the fight, and it turns it into a 4v5 situation. The fact that they're coming out on top is amazing, but they're still losing a hero in the fight, in like the beginning of the fight. And he's building up a 4-staff, so he should be able to finally, you know, once he gets that 4-staff, it should finally be less of a sacrifice and more of a tactical initiation. As he will be able to get out of the cogs.
Yeah,
but it looks like it's going to be another 5v5 here.
Barras is a little bit scared because if his beta rune is going to cancel out, he's going to get another boss. And that probably means we need another second. And Yoki's talking about Cockatoo, I guess, the bird. Ganga Jutes. Honestly, this. I can't read this at all. I'm not even going to try anymore.
Yeah, apparently
I've learned
the
something
H
today. The H is means an. Was it? N. H means N.
I believe. No, yeah. I think it's N meets H. No, I'm not sure.
No, H means N, yeah, yeah.
Right. Talking so, about vodka. Spectator chat at its finest, ladies and gentlemen. Unfortunately, Sander will be on it yet.
I can look at it now. I have it on. Let's see if something happens. Actually, 8,000 viewers here in game right now to watch the game without commentary.
Interesting. I've been trying to put some shameless advertising out, but unfortunately it doesn't work.
At least you try, I guess. The brackets. I don't know if. Let's see, is this the brackets?
Yeah, no, Necto actually just gave us the brackets again in chat.
Necto is moderating now, so he can just give the brackets.
Pretty nice. Thank you to him.
Yeah, all the work he's been doing. Really nice. A little bit of a
this would be the round
here.
Of the 16.
This round 16, yeah. After this, it's either going to be PR or the team that they're playing against that I don't know. After that, it's, I believe, Hellraiser or somebody else. I have the phaser thing open here as well. Oh, they're going to go back into game. Danish Bears or most likely Hellraiser, either of those two, I would say. Did Hellraiser win? I'll just keep the camera on recovery for a real second while I check it up.
No, they did not. In fact, the game isn't even over yet.
Okay, so they're still in game for Hellraisers versus Florida. Who the hell plays in Florida?
Smoke's up.
Okay. Yeah, they smoke up. They're gonna look for something. What will they find?
Oh, this could be actually be very bad. Very bad for the Empire's side here. All the calls are now just going away from the situation. They do not want to get caught out here.
Yeah, they kind of know that what's happening. There is no one on the side of Priest on the lanes. As recovery goes straight onto No Fear. No Fear will take a fall as Rave King picks up the kill.
But in the meantime, Empire will start pushing through top, so.
Let's see.
Yeah, No Fear has No Fear here.
There are 5 TPs on the side of Priest, so.
They're going right for Rosh.
Yeah, they're gonna go for the trade. Recovery provides a DD. Oh, come on.
Yeah, they really want to top now. If they don't take Rosh top, this could be risky. However, they need to take it quickly.
There's a fortification. They're gonna fortify. They're gonna fort. They might just defend this here. Sonic Wave hits, but doesn't kill off anybody. Just brings them a little bit low. Maybe I've had a gold seeker now.
No, that's a bit of an advantage though. Now TPing in is very risky.
Yeah, Resolution there was a nice idea to go for him, but you need to TP out as he will. The vacuum.
No.
Curse now comes out. But it's around Resolution. Gold Embrace. They do have some magic damage, but they're just going to Fiend Script and say,
hello.
We're going to go with it.
Hello.
No, Barrage. BKB, TP out. They don't want to use Aegis for nothing here. Oh, Goblok. He's going to take a fall as well. It's going to be Resolution for the elf laner plus Goblok. Silent is still going to go for more. He finds Ken, but he's not able to stop this TP. Queen of Pain goes in and either double clicked it or clicked on herself, and Yoki goes up in the air.
I think it's the latter. I think he was planning to click onto Lina. But two for the Clockwork, who has been basically the sacrificial lamb this whole game. Okay, and they managed to take the tier 2. Roshan does fall, but in the end, I think this is a better trade-off for Empire.
Two towers, two kills, lost one. In the end, I would say kinda. One thing is that if Priest is able to get a good team fight off this Aegis, but they might just push Rex somewhere, depending on where the fight is. And who survives. That's the one problem.
Yeah, they've been very aggressively using smoke. I really want to see what their smoke cooldown is at the moment. I will check quickly.
Smoke of the Seed on Priest side. Six minutes. They do have one on Goblack though.
They can use one more smoke in the next 6 minutes, and if they can use that to their advantage, they will probably very well push Rax.
And let's see, the smoke for Empire is 1 minute and 12 seconds.
Where is the smoke up on? Winter Wyvern?
No. 1 minute 20, 1 minute 10 for Empire before they can buy one.
They already used all their smokes? Interesting.
Oh, yeah. I did check the courier. The courier is nothing, so. Yeah. Silent sends the courier to the shop. Having no HOD, I think this is going to be Butterfly, and there you go, Eagle Song purchased.
On to, yeah, that's a very good item for Gyro right now, who can just avoid all the physical damage then. Really, there's only two heroes he needs to really take the physical from, which would be Wraith King and Shadow Fiend. BKB, oh, there you go. Final smoke for the next 5 minutes being used. In fact, they're even.
Was it not straight underneath this Radiant Vision Ward? I think it was.
Yeah, they should have spotted this out.
I think they saw this.
Yep, they did.
They're just keeping back all the way back to the tier 2 here, as they know that they're not going to rotate to the tower. They're going to rotate somewhere else. They're going to look for heroes on top.
That was a mistake. That's why you don't smoke in the enemy jungle, guys.
No, that's why you don't smoke without putting down a sentry.
Well, what a wasted smoke. And that's 5 minutes, I believe. 4:30 for the next smoke.
Yeah, essentially 5 minutes plus, was it?
The Aegis is wasted too, actually. That's a pretty good point right there.
2 minutes, yeah, or they need to force a fight now, somehow, by pushing in a lane. They can do top.
It's
going to
be really hard. Like,
they can do top.
Even if they... Yeah, I mean, okay, fine, but I think...
Empire will trade, for sure. Yeah.
So, not really forcing a fight, more like forcing a trade, and that's also not the outcome they really want. Are you charging up the Requiem there?
Maybe just for fun. They do have this nice aggressive ward from the bidder. But yeah, they're gonna look for tier 2.
They have fault up though, so... It's not sacking it, no.
Okay, the chat says that PR just won their match, so the winner of this, Priest or Empire, is gonna go up against PR. I believe they're now called Arcade Power Rangers, something like that. New sponsor.
They lose their tier 2 and even have to deny their tier 2 bot, so... That's a good trade-off for Priest right there. Oh, in fact, Priest is still looking for something.
Let's see if the eggs were loaded.
Oh dear.
Oh, Silent would be a big kill, but they're not able to find him. No fear goes Infis. Are they able to stop him? No, they're not. Well, at least the sentry blocks the camp, I guess. And they know where the sentry from from the city of Empire is. That's that Empire knows that there's a ward up there as well, so... Will we see a fight over that?
Look at, like, Dire Vision, like, you just look at the Dire Vision. They have the entire Radiant side of the jungle warded up.
Aloha Dancer? What?
You should be able Dire. Like,
oh, I mean, Aloha Dancer was going for the ward there, but I think he saw it. Yeah, there we go. He's gonna go for it again. Now he has some vision of it. Yeah, if you look at the range vision, that really does have this one ward.
Priest did get some good trade-offs there, and the network, however, is still looking on the side of Empire. Anything can happen right now.
It's not big.
Arguably, Empire has the advantage in the late game. Just because of Gyrocopter, mainly. I feel like a Gyrocopter versus the other team. I feel like the Gyrocopter just comes out on top there.
Yeah, he has the big AoE flag cannon that can do a lot. That's it.
Also, Cold Embrace. Sorry, Curse of the Winter. Curse, Winter's Curse.
Yeah, but that said, once you get some BKBs, it all becomes less and less effective. So. Brave King doesn't have a BKB yet.
Isn't that like Winter's Curse? Isn't that the exact purpose you want to use it for? Like, exactly when they pop the BKB, you pop the Winter's Curse on them, and then...
No, you can only use it now for the person that has the BKB activated. If you use the person next to it, he can just keep on walking.
Yeah, that's the point, though. It's like, you waste the BKB. 3.5 seconds of BKB timing in the late game will mean more than half of the BKB wasted.
I still 7 seconds up right now on Barash's BKB.
Okay. Well, that's exactly half. that requires Winter Wipe to be level 16, of course. He's only level 11 right now. And they will trade, actually. Will they trade? No, they're TPing back. They want to fight this.
Yeah, they don't want to give away 3 tier 2s here right now. Resolution. Yeah, the hookshot is going to get blocked by the creeps here. I don't think he can get it off the range, yeah. Not even close enough.
Yeah, priests aren't playing aggressive anymore. I just noticed that as well. They're playing very defensive and being more like guerrilla tactics. They're moving in to take care of the towers. And otherwise, they're not trying to force any fights.
And they're just afraid of the big AoE combination. The Disruptor has his Aghanims, and that makes the team fight for Empire so much more scary. The only thing that they need to make sure is that they don't stack over the Winter Scourge with the Static Storm too much. You're gonna lose too much time on either of them. Yeah. Depends. If Disruptor can get off his Static Storm before the BKB spot, yes.
Oh, the recovery
though. Did he get caught out or did he catch somebody else out? It seems to be that they still want to go after recovery here. They have some vision. The Rock is gonna come out now as well. Yeah, they're gonna. What? They're missing. No, he's still alive! Arm the toggle, Brave. No, the Glimmer Cave.
There you go. Oh, okay, Scream finally. Sonic Wave, finishing him off.
Fall down.
Fall down.
Oh, that's the blink back. Yeah, now he's there. Okay, this is like the one thing I talk about. This is the one thing you shouldn't do. It's a little bit too overstacking, but it doesn't really matter that much. This means that they don't have it for the fight. If it goes any further, Escond is caught out. We'll die as well. Seems like Priest just want to run. Down.
Oh, the Empire can now really push through here. He doesn't even wake, he doesn't even have buyback.
That's 50 seconds down, yeah, that's gonna cost you a lane of Rex. Oh, just to finish up against the Disruptor X, yeah, if you get caught this next storm, then you can't activate your BKB, but if your BKB is already activated, you can just walk out of there.
Uh-oh.
So, they get the first 3 for you. Still nothing to stop it. Lee Rex down. Range, they're gonna leave, they just wanna go top. No fear, starts tanking in with the Golden Brazil.
All the creeps are in fact taking up the range by themselves. Goodbye, Range Rex.
Sheevas is gonna be completed now by Yoki, just delivered. Sonnet has his butterfly as well. Are they gonna go for the range here? They're a little bit split up here, yeah. This is a little bit more way around. Small vacuum here, not doing enough. Resolution has hookshot as well as 4 steps to get out. Even gets glimmered up for a good measure. Oh, no fear. Yeah, okay, he's safe. But they're not following.
Right, most of the cores are now safe, so I guess that's a good retreat by Empire's on Empire's side now. In fact, everyone is now safe. So, really good trade-off for Empire there. Too much aggression from Priest just leads to them losing the Wraith King, and that turns the whole fight around on them. Suddenly, they can't defend anymore. Vacuum Wall was up for the whole duration of them attacking the Rags, but what would have it done?
Not enough, that's the problem, because I didn't have enough people to defend. Like, you need the Wraith King.
Like, you need at least the Lina as well, like... Yeah. Like, are you gonna go Rosh again?
Yeah. Rocket is coming out already. Here we go. Let's pull it out. Are they gonna go ball zips and just go for it? It seems like it, as...
They are!
Empire know it, and they're walking in. Silent. Rocket is coming out, he's gonna go again. Now the cooldown comes out, so Yoki goes in. Blinks in, gets off. Oh, just look at this. Oh. They're all stuck in it. Curse of the now also comes out. A little bit overstacking again, but this doesn't matter because they get the 2 kills. Now, Recovery tried to blink out, was able to do so. Goes after low, then, but he just gets Cold Embrace, and all the physical damage doesn't mean jack shit, as Empire don't even care about the wall. They just casually walk through it. now they're going to go and take Rush
themselves. And the SF just 275 masters is also pretty nice. I mean, he's the top farmer for Priest's team and was immediately blown up, like just at the beginning of the fight. That was beautiful static storm though by the disruptor.
Yeah, just having Yoki go in, putting the Shadow Fiend up in the air, making sure that he can pop his BKB, and then just have the static storm ready for him. Man, they just screwed him over entirely.
So yeah, easy Roshan for them now, and at this point, Kreese have to think, what can we do to win this? What can we do to come back from this? And the answer is really...
win two
difficult.
Or three fights?
Yeah.
Because with that, you just went... it went from like 4k, they got like a 10k gold swing at least.
Oh my god. Yeah,
it just goes up.
There, that is...
they're gonna take a tier 2 now as well.
Scary.
So it's going to be a little bit more gold as well, it's just such a big swing. Low end, still invis here, but yeah, they have a tier, they have a tower up, so it isn't really that big of a play to be. Yoke just goes in aggressive with the Aegis here. They do the exact same again, only Baros is not able to get out of it. As they're gonna get up the Falcon Wall here, but they're gonna get killed on the Loa Dance. No fear, it's now also still stuck there. They're just waiting for the Golden Racer and to kill him off. I think this is gonna be the end of this push. As Empire got overconfident and needs to leave ASAP.
That was a bit too much hyper aggression right there. They decided, we can win this anyway, so let's just go in for that. And they immediately get punished for that. 2,500 gold lost there, 3,425 XP. What did they gain? Not much, really. They take like 200 health away from the tower. Great.
Yeah, it's not worth the life of the two supports.
Well, the gold swing will not be that obvious
it's not
in the net worth.
Yeah, it's fairly minimal. I don't think it's really updated yet, but still, it's not that big. And yeah, it's just support. Like, what is it? The lowest. Oh no, second lowest. Oh, actually, a lower dance is more farm than resolution. My bad, so. They were better off losing resolution.
Who's actually trying to build up an axe now?
Let's see. Oh, resolution has more XP, so they gain more XP out of the kill on a lower dance. They would get more XP out of the kill on a resolution. So.
And the lower dance. No, resolution actually has his axe now, so.
12 second hook shot. Confirmed.
Lovely. Lovely. And this should mean, however, he should be a bit more present in these fights. And not try and be a sacrificial lamb. He hasn't been, actually. Yoki's been more or less the YOLO player, moving in here, yulzing someone up, and letting Disruptor do his work, but... now, let's see if what Resolution can do with his eggs.
It's all waiting, indeed, for the next big fight. Will the eggs make a big play? It means that they can just go for a little bit more happy-go-lucky hook shots, because even at the previous engagement I bought, he still had his hook shot, so
he probably will be a bit more willing to use it now.
Indeed.
And Satanic is up on Gyrocopter, though we didn't mention that. That means that that flak cannon is gonna actually really hurt a lot for Radiant. Not in the sense that it will do a lot of damage, but just, well, even then it will do like 300 damage, but in the sense that he will just be healing up all the damage they do to him at the same time. And like, what damage can they do? Like, what damage can they really actually do to touch him? Because he has a butterfly, no one has an MKB. Nobody has a hex, nobody has any form of basically keeping him secured once he activates his BKB, which he just did.
He did get called in there, he's still a little bit stuck here. He activated the Satanic, but wasn't really able to do a whole lot of it. Barash is now going to get stuck in the Static Storm, but already used the BKB. This doesn't matter that much. His recovery is to arm the Togger and run away. They lose the gem right now, as they're going to follow up, and Barash is going to die as well. There's already 3 dead on the side of Priest. Now Goblock is going to be on the menu. But yeah, they're going to let him escape. They don't care too much about it. Since Barash bought back, Yoki's going to give away his Aegis here, maybe. No, he blinks out just in time. Oh, recovery goes forward, but the Golden Race on a lower dance is going to make sure that he's going to be alive. Resolution, they're going to try and get him, but the hookshot is there coming out. He will die in the end here to Barash, but it doesn't really matter. He's Now Silent activates another Satanic and just starts healing up 50% of HP back from one Satanic pop. Now can't put into the air as GG well played is called by Goblack. This is the end for Priest, but the road for Empire to the Major in Frankfurt is still very real.
What a game. That was probably the first actual challenge for Empire though, like the first real challenge. And they had some difficulties. You have to say that they really had some difficulties.
Yeah, just compare this time to the times of the games of yesterday. It's almost double. Like it is double.
Yeah, and you see, I mean, Priest was able to build up a lot of items on the heroes, but in the end, they just lost stupid fights.
Yeah, the
Rosh fight. You know, that was probably the turning point.
That's satanic. The eggs on Disruptor. That's in my eyes really just the big difference.
So good, it's so good. The item muting, it's just doom. AoE, it's so good.
Indeed, well, and ladies and gentlemen, that was the second game of today for Empire. They're gonna go into the quarterfinals now, where they're gonna be facing up against Power Rangers. We will be guessing that one as well. That will still be a best of one. Yeah, we'll see everybody then, I guess. This was @Morality_Class and me @Sender_Dota. We'll see you guys then.